If you use After Effects, you need to try this tool. Say I want to animate this logo, but I want to animate each of these shapes individually. Your first instinct might be to go ahead and create a mask for each of these shapes. You don't want to do that. There's already a feature built into After Effects to do that for you. All you got to do is select your layer, go up to layer, and go down to Auto-Trace. This will bring up a box, and what this feature does is it automatically traces and creates a mask for each of the shapes. This works best for images that don't have a background, like PNGs. You'll want to leave the channel on alpha, and the only thing you might want to adjust is the tolerance. The lower the number, the more accurate it'll follow the shapes. If you raise this up, as you can see, it doesn't really follow the shapes all that well. So we want this to be accurate, so we're gonna keep it 1. Go ahead and hit OK, and it creates a mask for each of those shapes for you automatically. You can then take those masks, convert them into shape layers, and animate them from there. This also works for images that don't have a transparent background. For example, say I want to get the squares inside of the Microsoft logo. If I go ahead and go up to Layer, Auto Trace, you can see that it's just doing the outside because that is the shape of the image. You can then mess around with the channel. Go down to red or green or blue, and you can kind of see what shapes will be created. Blue seems to be pretty good. It's getting almost all of the shapes that I need. So I'm gonna go ahead and click OK. And as you can see, it's created a mask for the outside and these three boxes. But I still need the blue square. So what I do in this case is I go to Effects and search in Color Key. I like to key out the other colors so that way when I do Auto Trace, it only has one option to choose from. I added 3 color keys and I'm gonna key out the other squares. And then when I go up to Layer, Auto Trace, I can then change it to red. And as you can see, the blue box, I mean, it's kind of hard to tell, but the blue box is now highlighted. I go ahead and hit OK. It created a bunch of masks. I don't need all of them. I just need this one. So I can go ahead and delete those other ones. And there you go. I now have a mask for each of these shapes. Even though this picture did not have a transparent background, I can then delete the color keys. I don't need those anymore. I can then take these masks and convert them into shape layers and animate them from there. If this tutorial helped you, make sure to leave a like and subscribe for more videos to come.